How did Etex do its bit for the Polish and European cultural experience? Let's take off on a journey to Krakow, Poland's second largest city. There, an exceptional piece of architectural delight is sure to catch your eye, the ICE Conference and Congress Centre. It boasts one of the best acoustics in Europe, setting a new benchmark for acoustics in concert and conference halls. Etex's Siniat company delivered and installed no less than 70,000 square meters of plasterboard for the Congress Center. 70,000 square meters is about the size of the basis of the Great Pyramid of Giza in Egypt and two soccer fields combined. But why did the ICE Congress Center developers ask Etex for so many of its Siniat plasterboards? That's easy. To have the right kind of product features to guarantee the best acoustics in the halls. In the concert hall, even the tiniest interior elements can influence a room's acoustics. Our plasterboards were cut out for the job though. The balcony cladding, the suspended ceiling, and even the petal-shaped acoustic cloak above the stage. It all bears the signature of our plasterboards. The same goes for the acoustic, suspended ceiling in the theatre hall. It consists of hundreds of little pyramids. These diffuse all the sounds and prevent them from echoing. But Siniat plasterboards have yet another treat in store. They also pave the way to sustainable building solutions. To find out how, we need to start at the very beginning, when plasterboards are nothing but a raw material. At the beginning of our manufacturing process, we extract gypsum rock from a quarry and transport it by truck to our production site. There, the rocks are crushed into small pieces and homogenized. To achieve that, we arrange the gypsum in different layers that cut across each other in a huge production hall. The grinding mill turns the gypsum into a very fine powder, smaller than a tenth of a millimeter in diameter. Afterwards, the gypsum is heated to 150 degrees Celsius. Once all the water content is removed from the gypsum, it turns into plaster. After a cooling process, a screw conveyor transports everything to a mixer. In just a few seconds, we make sure to place the plaster in water and add several additives. And then it's off to the board forming line. We pour the gypsum mixture between two huge rolls of paper. This slurry sandwich then passes through a pair of forming plates. In one single piece, the board travels down a long conveyor belt. Once we've cut the board to the right length, we flip it around and place it in a dryer. Then, the board hardens for 40 minutes and becomes virtually moisture-free. Now it's time to transfer the plasterboards to our warehouses, before transporting them to the construction site of the ICE Congress Center. But wait, a plasterboard's journey doesn't have to end there. One day, when architects or builders will rethink the building's purpose, it might have to be demolished. In that case, the resulting gypsum waste could be sent to a recycling plant, and then back to the plasterboard factory where it all started. For now, our plasterboards are still stealing the show at the ICE Congress Center in Poland. There, they'll be guaranteeing the best acoustics for decades to come, so that thousands of people can enjoy music and theatre performances in the best possible way.